Good morning. My name is Katie Holderby, and I'm the Director of Alumni Engagement, and I have the honor of introducing Chancellor Chris Holford from
Good
Purdue.
morning.
Good morning, Chancellor. How are you?
I'm doing very well. Happy to be here.
Thank you. And also, Mayor Thomas McDermott. We're going to talk about Mayor McDermott today because we're going to talk about the Purdue Northwest Alumni Hall of Fame, and he's one of our inductees. Congratulations.
Thanks, Katie. Nice to see you.
Good to see you.
Thanks for the
Good
invite.
Good to see you. But before,
congratulations for me too.
Thank you.
What a great honor. We're so excited to have you in the Hall of Fame. We were already installing your picture in the university. Yes, it'll be all covered up.
I hope it's one of my good ones. I have some bad pictures.
Yeah. I think it's a good one.
Chancellor, congratulations. I heard this is your
Thank
first
you.
Radio show.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
My first show is the Chancellor.
First show
and,
is Chancellor.
And we were excited to have you be one of the guests on that show.
All right. I'm going to be a good boy today. I'm not going to make anybody mad. So I don't want the Chancellor's first show. I'm not going to start it off on the wrong foot. So,
We trust you.
Thank you, Katie. I appreciate
it's
it.
It's all about you today.
Thank you. I appreciate it, Katie.
It is.
Before we get started, I'm going to talk about some upcoming items and events at Purdue Northwest. It is March. It is Women's History Month, and we have many events going on at Purdue Northwest through March 28th. And if you'd like more information, you can visit pnw.edu/women's-history for all events, dates, times, and locations. In addition to that, PNW scholarship deadline, this is for all of our students. Make sure to apply for PNW's 2024-25 academic year scholarships before the deadline, which is March 22nd. That is tomorrow. So tomorrow is the deadline for scholarships. Students can access our new scholarship service through Scholarship Universe from their cell phones or computers. The service will help match students to their best suited scholarships. And for more information on that, visit pnw.edu/paying-for-college. Once again, that's pnw.edu/paying-for-college. We have our Honors College 5K Community Walk. Join the PNW Honors College Walk. It begins at 9 a.m. on Saturday, April the 6th, and that will start at the Fitness and Recreation Center in Hammond. The event raises funds for Fair Haven Rape Crisis Center. Students, faculty, staff, alumni, community members are invited. And to register, please visit pnw.edu/event. In addition to that, we love to talk about sports, right? So I'm going to talk about some sports updates at PNW for the weekend. Our spring sports action this weekend include baseball and softball. PNW Baseball will host a doubleheader against Davenport on March 22nd, that's tomorrow, and Wayne State on March 24th. Softball will have a doubleheader as well against Davenport on March 23rd and Grand Valley State on March the 24th. For more information, visit pnwathletics.com, pnwathletics.com. All right, let's get started. Let's talk about Hall of Fame. I'm just going to give a brief overview for our listeners about the Alumni Hall of Fame. This inductee session, which is in 2 weeks, it's in 2 weeks from today. It'll be on Thursday, April the 4th. We are recognizing Mayor Thomas McDermott of Hammond, also the Honorable Diane Cavadia-Schneider and Jeff Strack. So we're looking forward to that. The Hall of Fame honors alumni who are high-achieving leaders in their field, involve members of their communities, and those who have engaged with PNW well beyond their time as students. These three inductees will be honored on Thursday, April 4th, during a reception and dinner hosted in Alumni Hall at the Student Union and Library Building on our campus. So with that, we'll get started. We'll jump right in because we're so honored to have one of our inductees here this morning. And we'll open it up with talking about your experiences at PNW. I know we're going back a little bit.
No,
we won't tell anyone how far back, but we're going back a little bit.
Let me see. It was 1994, late 1993. I just got out of the Navy. I was And at the time, if you were accepted as a full-time college student, they would let you out of the military a little bit early, which was important to me because I was on a submarine. It was very active, and I was accepted to Purdue Northwest.
How long were you in the service?
I was in the Navy for 6 years. I was on submarines for 4. So I would literally dream about Purdue Northwest and how awesome it was going to be going there while I was studying for college underneath the main engines. I mean, not even kidding. And I would just, like, look forward to the day I went to college. So when I was accepted to Purdue, I was let out of the Navy about a month early, which for me was important because I would have had to miss the whole semester. Right. And then I reported to Purdue Calumet at the time, and I was the happiest college student you've ever met because I just got out of the Navy, and I was motivated and happy to be there. And I think my professors loved me because I was truly happy to be sitting there. But I love Purdue. Calumet at the time. I love Purdue Northwest because for me, when I got out of the Navy, I had 2 kids. I needed to have a full-time job, and Purdue Northwest was perfect for me. It allowed me to work full-time, and I also went to school full-time, and I did that for 3 years straight until I graduated and ultimately was accepted to Notre Dame. So.
Well, first of all, thank you for your service.
Thank you. I appreciate it, Chancellor.
But secondly, thank you for picking Purdue Northwest to come get your degree. I think that the story you're telling right mm-hmm. now is similar to the experience a lot of our students have had, where they're hardworking students, they're interested in advancing their degree, they're interested in the social mobility that they're going to get at the end of a college degree, but they're trying to work 20 or 30 hours to help support a family or do other things. That's very typical of a lot of our student body and something we're very sensitive to.
Mm-hmm. So it was important for me, Chancellor. It was one of the, you know, I've lived right on 169th Street, right across the street from the campus. I worked for NIPSCO at the time. I'd work during the day for NIPSCO, and I'd walk across the street every night and go to school at Purdue. And I did that. And the instructors, to this day, I'm still real close to a lot of my instructors. Pat Obey being one of my favorites. He was really important to me when
and
I got up.
I think when you look at other people that have been inducted to the Hall of Fame, they have a similar story mm-hmm. where things were going on in their life and their family, and they've gone on to be successful professionals, and we've had the ability to recognize and honor the commitments they've made back to the university. And I know you're a big supporter of things that are going on at our university.
Yes, sir.
And have been for years.
As mayor, you know, when I came back as mayor, it gave me a great opportunity to work closer with the chancellors, and all three chancellors, while I've been mayor, have been wonderful people, yourself included, Chancellor.
Thank you.
And we've got a lot of things done over the years, and I was part of the dorm expansion, you know, obviously the athletic expansion I was part of. I even coached first base for the baseball team for 3 seasons, so I love Purdue. I get in trouble because I have 2 colleges in the city, and obviously I'm partial to Purdue because I'm an alum, and, you know, I get criticism from the other college sometimes. I have to sort of temper my enthusiasm because we're lucky in Hammond to have 2 colleges, but Purdue is my alma mater. Right. I live in the neighborhood, so I'm a real proud alum.
Well, thank you for that.
And how did PNW prepare you for – I know you went on to law school mm-hmm. at University of Notre Dame. How did it prepare you for that?
Taking college courses with a guy like Pat Obey prepared me, and it, you know, and I had great instructors. And I always talk about Pat a lot, but Pat and I became real close, and he was, to me, he's a PhD and just like this brilliant person, and he was just so relatable. And it's, you know, I don't think if I was going to Purdue West Lafayette, for instance, I don't think I would get that interaction with a person like Pat Obey.
Right.
You know, the PhDs are a lot more distant when you go to a larger campus, but I was talking to Pat every day of my life when I was a very impressionable 24-year-old, and he was a big influence on me. And to this day, we're still friends. Him and I traveled to China together on a trip between Purdue and the city of Hammond, by the way. But so Pat, and it's just people like that. I mean, the thing about Purdue, you know, Ed Ferticella, one of my banking instructors, mm-hmm. still a wonderful person, and we still talk. You know, Shomir is still a doctor that was an instrumental part of my life. So to this day, I'm still thankful to those people because I don't think I'd be mayor. I know I wouldn't be mayor if it wasn't for Purdue Northwest. I know I wouldn't have gone to law school. Right. You know, it was important for me. I needed to be able to go to school, and I needed a flexible education so that I could also work. And that's what Purdue Calumet /Northwest did for me at the time.
I think that's one of the big advantages of coming to a university like Purdue Northwest is you're going to be exposed to real high quality faculty in their classroom, not graduate students teaching a lot of courses. And I think that's another common experience, that you develop a relationship with the faculty members, And then they go on because they get to know you and help write strong letters for you as you go on and try to do other things. And I think that's one of the real advantages we offer over a much larger campus.
That's exactly what happened, Chancellor. All my instructors that were so instrumental in my career at Purdue, they all wrote great letters of recommendation for me, and I got into Notre Dame Law School. And I don't know how many Purdue Calumet – excuse me, I'm going to cop. It was Calumet when I went, but it's Purdue Northwest, and I'm really good about that. But I don't know how many – you know, Purdue Northwest graduates went to Notre Dame Law School, but I was one of them, and I was proud of that, and I carried that banner proudly. When people would say, "Oh, you're a Boilermaker," I was like, "Nope, I'm from the Pride." You know, I'm Purdue Calumet Northwest at the time, and you know, so. Well, I'm going to stop saying Calumet.
That's okay.
I'm going to stop, okay. Chancellor. You guys have done a really good job of branding, and I'm just talking about historical. Yeah. It was that, but I love PNW. I think it's a great institution. I'm glad the name changed, and I go by PNW, right. But so I'm going to stop saying
that. That's certainly one of our legacy campuses.
It is.
That was your experience when you were matriculating through that program.
But now, you know, honestly, I can appreciate where you've come, though, because I've seen it when it was Purdue Calumet, and I see it now as PNW, and it's night and day. It is night and day. I may not even got accepted at PNW.
Well, I mean, I think that's one of the important facets of what we did. We are fundamentally sort of a different type of university now. Probably in the days that you were here, we probably had about 100 athletes total.
Yeah.
We have close to 500 athletes now, and we're continuing to look for our opportunity to expand more. We competed in the NAIA. Now we're NCAA Division II school. There have been a lot of changes, and even the physical appearance on our campus has changed a lot over the years with some of the old buildings coming down and us renovating the spaces. What we're focused on is accentuating what you just talked to the listeners about. The student experience is important to us.
Yeah.
And all of our renovations have had the student experience in mind, creating a quality student experience with a lot of opportunity to participate in co-curricular and extracurricular activities. So I've been here now almost 25 years, and I would say, just like you, I'm very proud of where we've come as an institution and what we're trying to do in the next 3 to 5 years.
Yes, sir. I buy into it, and I believe it, and I'm part of the vision, and I want to help from where I sit in the city of Hammond's mayor seat. So.
And I think that's important. I think that we've seen the transformation and the partnership with the city of Hammond when you look at the campus. And also Dowling Park, we're talking about sports a little bit. I know that's an important partnership with Purdue Northwest and the city of Hammond. So let's talk about that a little bit. You know, we're Division II now, and sports has changed a lot since you went to Purdue Cal. So
I think they only had a basketball team when I was a student, and not many people paid attention because – and now it's real. It's D2. You got great athletes from all over the United States here. I see them running through my neighborhood. It's great. It's
and
a vibrance
beyond,
it brings.
Outside of the United States.
Yeah,
for
sure.
International students.
A lot of
playing.
International students.
Yeah, but it's like a vibrance that you bring, just that young energy – you know, because I'm 55, I'm an old guy. So I'm sitting in my neighborhood, you know, like aching and painting, and then all these young kids go running by, and you're like, it just brings a vibrance to the whole area that we haven't had for a long time.
Well, and I think that we've gotten to the point where this year alone we've had post-conference play appearances in our national tournaments, the men's soccer team in the fall, and I had the opportunity in the last week to drive down to St. Louis and watch our young men compete in the hockey national tournament.
That makes me happy.
Which was super exciting for
me. It's cool. It is really cool. I mean, we have a hockey team, and I know, Chancellor, we've been in discussions about even growing that program, and I buy into your vision, and I think that PNW is a great university, and I'm really lucky that, you know, I went there, and I'm really lucky to live close to it, and Hammond's super lucky.
Well, and we will be bringing in the fall, this morning on the earlier show, Madison Samples was here, and our new stunt coach. We're bringing stunt to the university, competitive cheer gymnastics, and I think we'll be the first institution in Indiana to have that as an NCAA sport. So another first happening at Purdue Northwest.
That's great. Congratulations. They should. You should get thrown for the first official toss. They should have the chancellor.
Yeah.
You could show your confidence.
They should throw him or
him. Yeah, just to show confidence. I trust you guys. You know,
I will say one of the highlights for me in my first sort of week was getting to drop the puck.
Oh, nice.
When we played the University of Illinois.
Good for you.
as somebody that grew up in Illinois and, you know, U of I is a powerhouse institution, having the University of Illinois up to our ice up here at the Cube.
Yes, sir.
And I got to walk out and drop the puck, the ceremonial puck.
How cool.
But it was very exciting for me seeing where we've come as an institution, who we're competing against now as an institution.
Well, that reminds me of when we first started the ice hockey program a couple of years ago, University of Michigan and Purdue Northwest played at Bulldog Park.
Yeah.
That was for me. That was really cool.
Yeah.
Like, you know, Wolverines coming into town. I mean, it's cool stuff what you guys are doing, and that's only going to get bigger and better, which is awesome. And your team is already great. So
let's talk about that bigger and better. What do we see happening next? What future partnerships between PNW and the city of Hammond?
If I were to dream, you know, I do. I'm, you know, when I was a first base coach for Purdue Northwest, I learned a lot. I was coaching with Dave Griffin, who's an awesome baseball coach, and he's been there since the team started. He's just a great guy. But Dave and I got an opportunity to see a lot of things from a coach's perspective, and I know the Chancellor buys into this vision, and we're working through particulars, but I think ultimately Purdue Northwest needs to take a larger presence in Dowling Park and that whole area, because I think it complements the program so well, and I know the Chancellor's interested in this. I mean, we're sorting through a lot of the particulars with our people, but I think that's a good vision to have, and you know, and PNW is also, you know, looking at the old Gabbett High School. I know we've talked about that as well, and I'm not trying to give too much away here because the Chancellor's got great vision, but the Chancellor's vision and my vision align really well together. So,
well, now that you've mentioned that, I heard you speak at the LCEA yesterday about developments going downtown, and I have shared with you, I am personally very excited about what you're doing in the downtown area.
Thank you.
And could you share a little bit about the projects that are going to, similar to what you shared yesterday?
Sure. Yeah. Well, PNW and the City of Hammond, we partner a lot. And one of the partnerships that was brought to us by PNW and by the Franciscans moving out was there's the old wound center that's right there along Holman Avenue. It's basically, if you look at the old Franciscan property, it's the northeast corner of the property. There's a building that's relatively new. It was built in the 80s, I believe, that Purdue Northwest is interested in. And what we're trying to do is bring the data center that's in Cermak in downtown Chicago with quantum level capability. We're trying to attach a node from the data center in Hammond to downtown Hammond, where Purdue Northwest would have their impact lab. And I know Purdue Northwest is interested. I know we're interested. I know the Franciscans are interested. I know that the people with the data center are interested. Right. And it seems like everything's coming together. And, you know, I'm not a tech guy, but from what I understand, this technology is very, you know, it's not easy to replicate. It's not available anywhere.
Well, I mean, I think it's fair to say what makes that so exciting is the transformational moves you've done in the downtown Hammond area.
Thank you.
There are a lot of things going down. It's going to be very exciting when all, and I know those are years in the making to pull that off.
Yeah.
But I really think that's going to be transformational for the downtown area, and we're going to be excited to be in that area and to have a physical presence in that area, because I really do think with the development of the housing that's going in there, the double tracking, the station that's going in there, your vision for transforming that area is really fantastic,
Thank you.
It makes it exciting to want to be part of that.
I appreciate it. And when Purdue's part of any project, it's always successful. I mean, I'm standing in a building right now that I was talking to the Chancellor and Katie before we came on. This used to be my campaign headquarters, and it looks beautiful now compared to that. WJOB has done a great job, but Purdue bought this building and retrofitted the whole thing and brought WJOB into here and basically turned this whole building. This was a struggling medical center, and now it's a thriving part of Purdue's campus. So when Purdue talks about the Impact Lab in downtown Hammond, I see a great partnership and a university that's willing to follow through on their commitments. So it's a good start for us because we want to make, you know, lemonade out of lemons. And obviously the hospital's closure and Hammond was a big deal, but we're trying to make the best of it, and I think having a partnership with Purdue is a great first step.
Well, thank you.
Yeah, and to see on Indianapolis Boulevard as we look north, there's we can see the Purdue Northwest logo, and
yeah,
I think more projects like that hopefully are on the horizon.
I think they are. Yeah.
So, Chancellor, why don't you talk about some other projects that Purdue Northwest has been involved in? I know that when we talk about the hydrogen hub and some other big projects, what else do you think is on the horizon?
Well, I mean, I think the mayor has mentioned one of them. We're very interested in the commercialization entrepreneurship aspect of the potential that quantum computing will bring to Northwest Indiana. You know, certainly when you buy a house, it's location, location, location. And I think that the city of Hammond, Purdue's presence here, create an ideal opportunity for us to be part of what I am going to imagine is going to be a huge thing across the country, the development of quantum technologies. In addition to that, we've been very successful in the last 3 years, receiving a lot of funding from the Department of Energy for industrial scale decarbonization efforts. We're a partner in the Mach H2 project, so it's incorporating a lot of things that are centrally important to the manufacturing sector in Northwest Indiana, from BP to the steel mills and their operation, to NIPSCO and power and energy generation in here. We have a footprint in all of those, and largely that's in the industrial decarbonization space, which is of national importance. And I think it is fair of me to say we're one of the statewide leaders, if not one of the national leaders in industrial decarbonization. More than $24 million in federal research dollars brought into our campus here in Northwest Indiana. We're quickly becoming, as a non-research institution, one of the largest non-research institutions to receive that level of support from the federal government. And I think it's, you know, a lot of factors weigh into that. The relationship we have with the city, the proximity to water, the supply of power, the rail system that's going here, the internet trunk running out of Chicago towards the East Coast, all the confluence of all those factors means it's, again, I'm very excited for what the next 3 to 5 years is going to look like. Underlying this is the central mission of our institution is to produce the highest quality skilled workforce. So we at the university are preparing for not the jobs of today, but what the jobs of tomorrow are going to look like. So as the mayor brings new businesses into Northwest Indiana, into Hammond, we are going to have the workforce prepared for those companies to move in. And access to workforce is one of the most important factors in economic development. And so the university's committed to looking forward and saying, well, how do we need to prepare tomorrow's students to jump immediately out of our university post-graduation and get these jobs? And that'll make it attractive to bring businesses in when we can supply that workforce. Mm-hmm.
And everything that's happening in Hammond right now, especially downtown, because with skilled workforce, you need housing, you need mm-hmm. amenities, and all of those things that come with trying to bring skilled workforce to our area. So it's all important. Well, with that, I know we have to wrap up in a couple minutes. So I just want to talk about briefly, because we're here because you're being inducted into
Thank
the
you.
Hall of Fame.
That's
and
a great honor.
We want to make sure we leave a message with our future alumni and talk about our future inductees and those things that they need to do. But you're a good inspiration, you and your peers,
yes,
which
absolutely.
Include Jeff Strack. With Strack and Van Til, and also Judge Schneider, who is a Lake County judge for more than 30 years.
Right.
So
we all know each other really well, too.
That's oh, good.
It's going to be a cool class. Night. I mean, I don't know how often it is you're getting inducted with – I practiced in front of Judge Schneider, and Jeff and I know each other really well. So, and, I think the two colleagues I'm getting inducted with are amazing. Judge Schneider's outstanding, and Jeff Strack, obviously, has done a great job with Strack and Van Til. So it's a great honor. Anytime you're recognized by your university, it's a tremendous honor. I was blown away when I was nominated.
Well,
so.
Our Hall of Fame only has 7 people in it total, and all 7 of these people are so impressive in what
Thank
you've
you.
Gone on to do with your career and the influence you've had on Purdue Northwest and our trajectory,
Thank
the
you.
Support that group of 7. It's a very impressive group that you're joining, and boy, we're proud to have
I'm
you
proud
as part of that.
I appreciate it, Chancellor, a lot, actually, and I'll always be associated with this university because it changed my life. Purdue Northwest
that's,
changed my life.
That's
I was
great.
When I came out of the Navy, I needed help, and Purdue Northwest was there for me, and I appreciate it to this day. And I'm 55 years old, and I still longingly talk about PNW. So
not to put you on the spot, but mm-hmm. what message would you leave with our students?
I love PNW because I think that, you know, we live in the region while you're going to school here, and in the region, it's really practical, hardworking, mm-hmm. blue-collar people, but you're also getting a great education that you would get in places like Bloomington or West Lafayette. So you're getting the best of both worlds here. You're getting a real practical education. And for somebody like me, I was a blue-collar, practical person anyway. So to get the education I got at PNW allowed me to go off to Notre Dame and do the things I do. And without PNW is a basic building block in my DNA. Without that basic building block, I wouldn't be where I am today. There's no doubt in my mind. I'm not just saying that either. There's no doubt in my mind. Right. I would not be standing here without PNW. So that's why I give
that.
Thank
you for that comment.
Yeah, thank you.
That's the thing that makes us proud.
Yes, sir. Right. I mean, it's the truth. It's the truth. And I'm very honored that I'm going to be in the Hall of Fame, and I'm going to try not to cry. So
there's a little bit of crying. I think there's a little crying last
year. It's cool.
Year.
I mean, it's a big honor, and I'm serious about it. It's a real big honor for me. So, and that's a cool plaque, by the way. It's going to be proudly displayed. So.
Well, with that, we want to thank you for being here today. We appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you, Chancellor.
Thanks for coming in.
It's good to see you. Congratulations on everything you're doing.
Thank you.
You hit the ground running, doing a great job.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It used to be so easy living here with you. You were light and breezy, and I knew just what to do. Now you look so unhappy. It's